What's the worst case of rich kid syndrome you've seen? I worked as a bouncer at a high-end nightclub. The biggest boner of a rich kid, straight out of Malibu's Most Wanted, gets a VIP booth and bottle service. Racks up a massive bill trying to act like a baller. His credit card gets denied and he has to call his dad to come down at 1:30 a.m. because he can't order any more bottles. His dad comes down in his pajamas. Obviously ashamed and furious at this douche of a kid. Ends up embarrassing the shit out of his kid in front of his whole group of friends. He takes the kid's keys and is about to leave when his kid makes some shitty comment and goes back in the club. The dad's about to walk away after he apologizes for his son when we offer to drag him out the rough way. He smiles and accepts. That kid hit every door and step on the way out. Not the best story, but was one of the most satisfying experiences working at that club. A 12-year-old family friend got an iPhone XS for his birthday, then deliberately shattered his iPhone 8. I saw a 7-year-old daughter having iPhone XS with Dior ostrich skin cover. The cover was more expensive than the phone. Mommy got it for her birthday. In high school, a kid was bragging that he got in his third fender bender in his old car, 3 years old, that his parents gave him but he hated, so his parents were buying him an entirely new, current year, car to incentivize him to drive better. Hey son, you wrecked your new car? Well, fine. We're getting you a new one hoping you'll drive better, genius. I went to school with a kid who totaled his Escalade, and someone's private land, by off-roading in it. So it was replaced with an Audi so they couldn't do it again. Dunno if it qualifies as rich kid syndrome, but when I got out of the Navy I decided to use my GI Bill at one of the Penn State satellites. I was sitting in the cafeteria drinking coffee and typing up a paper when a girl sits down across from me and opens her backpack. She pulls out a sandwich bag and looks at it in disgust, then looks me dead in the eye and says, "I don't even know why I bother, my mother never cuts off the crust." I let out one of those high-pitched short laughs like, "Is this girl for real?" Oblivious to the tone of it, she says, "I know right," then asks me if I want it. I looked around thinking I was getting pranked or something, cause this shit is too stereotypical to be real, and I just assumed I was being filmed. She shook it at me and gave me a well look. So I said fuck it and took the sandwich. She then pulled out her student ID card and bought a crap ton of French fries. That sandwich was awesome. I think the bread was homemade and it was stacked like a Dagwood. It had all kinds of expensive looking meats and Dijon mustard. Serious gourmet shit. I know this girl's mother will never see this, but I just wanna say someone appreciated that sandwich. My mom's friend used to buy new clothes each season and throw out the old ones. She had to be taught by her husband to save them for the next year. Did she never love a piece? I'd be pissed if I had to discard my favorite shirt. Or I love this shirt. Too bad it's expired and has to go into the incinerator. Worked with this kid who was a good kid, but completely disconnected from financial reality for most people. He'd just moved out west from another state and was trying to get on like a normal adult. He went to buy a new car and was shocked that they couldn't just bill his dad for it, since they didn't know him. He ordered a bottle of wine at a restaurant and the sommelier said, "Certainly, sir." Then the sommelier whispered, "Just for your knowledge, sir, the bottle is $700. He looked straight at him and asked, "Is that a lot?" The sommelier honestly didn't know how to answer. Good kid. And he got a lot better. But he just didn't know. Once he casually told his mom he needed some help with bills and she deposited $20,000 into his account. A guy looked at my $2,000 beta car in college and commented that it must have been really cheap and guessed $15,000. My friend's parents had a dilemma because they both bought each other new Mercedes for Valentine's Day. I worked at a Starbucks and we hired a new guy, who I was training. At one point, I had to show him how to clean the restrooms. I grab the bleach, and hand him a pair of gloves and he looks at me in disgust and says, "We don't have maid to clean the bathrooms." He quit the next day, lol. One of my college classmates wrecked his Range Rover over winter break and came back in an Aston Martin. In college I wrecked my 1998 Toyota and came back in a 1998 Toyota with the front bumper missing. Edit. Thank you so much to everyone that gave me these awards. I got a chuckle when I wrote this comment, so I'm glad a lot of other people found some joy in it too. In middle school we were asked to draw our homes for some assignment and hand it in at the end of class. A popular, extremely wealthy kid that sat behind me raised his hand and smugly asked the teacher for another sheet of paper because he couldn't draw it all on one page. His friends just snickered, but I was cringing. Even at 12 I remember thinking it was such a snobby thing to say. Bragging about your parents' money is honestly just sad. Went to school with a crazy rich kid. His parents divorced and each decided to buy his love. Mommy owned a real estate agency, so she got him a license and spoon-fed him enough sales for a six-figure income. The dad then bought him a magazine. Yes, the dad bought a magazine for his 24-year-old cokehead son to run. Worked about as well as you'd imagine. My fraternity brother's monthly allowance of $2,000 was cancelled from his parents because he made a few F's. He then called his aunt for a separate allowance. Edit, the dude was a massive douche. His dad is a very successful stockbroker in the Memphis Germantown area. The kid only went to college so he could earn a degree to work at that company. The kid already had it made from day one. I could write paragraphs on how big of a douche canoe this dude was. But honestly, every single person who's replied here is a better person than he was. Edit 2. He blew the money on Xanax and weed. Edit 3. The kicker of this story was not really the amount, but the fact that the kid called up his wealthy aunt for more money. Knew this one guy at my college who didn't understand why everybody is so worked up about student loans. I remember him saying something along the lines of, why don't people just pay the tuition up front? He was also quite sheltered. Just stop being poor. God. Well boys, we did it. Poverty is no more. My friend literally throws away his change because he hates holding coins. Doesn't matter if it's 99 cents, he'll throw it away. That shit adds up. Like, in the bin, in the trash, your friend needs a slap, with a coin purse. This kid back in high school was whining, I mean literally whimpering, that he had to wait something like 6 weeks for his custom-built BMW to come over from Germany. The Nintendo DS just came out. It was like $150 and my family lived in a cramped one-bedroom apartment and drove a 20-year-old car that was always breaking down. We ate those cheap bags of Walmart beans and rice for months at one point. I expressed the desire to own one after my friend said he had one and I got, why can't your parents just buy you one? I don't get it. It's dirt cheap. He didn't want to be my friend after that anymore. Literally avoided me and made fun of me for the rest of the year behind my back. I'm still salty about it. Maybe not rich kid syndrome, but middle class kid syndrome. I wouldn't say rich kid, but definitely spoiled brat who thought he was rich. Befriended him in 5th grade over our interest in the UGR trading card game. First time I hung out at his place, I noticed just how littered with stuff his room was. Some even unopened. I showed him some rare card that I had recently pulled from a pack. He got super jealous and angry that I wouldn't trade or sell it to him. He immediately got up and walked over to the family computer and booted up a site where you could buy cards and various other toys and such. Completely ignoring having me over, he's now on an online shopping spree adding stuff to the cart. After adding a few things, he yells, "Where's the credit card?" and immediately his older sister comes running up the stairs to yell, "Kyle, mom said no more buying stuff online," and closes the website and shuts off the computer. Kyle then proceeds to have a crying tantrum on the floor and I'm just standing there over him in shock at what's happening and how he's acting. I slowly stopped hanging out with him until completely avoiding him as his temperament got worse. Kid wasn't even rich either if I remember correctly, both of his parents were cops. Babysat some rich kids. A couple gems where when we were watching a movie and she said someone was ugly because they were poor. Another was that they left their stove at the side of the road for hobos. Kid was about 11. Apparently there was this 15-year-old girl who was going on an exotic vacation to some Pacific island or something. But her favorite show was on TV the day of their flight, and she really wanted to see it. Her parents delayed the flight so that she could watch an episode of her favorite show. I could absolutely survive on my own. My parents just pay for my food and house, but I pay for everything else. If I got a job, I could pay for my food and house too, said at 18. In the middle of a discussion between two middle-class peers who were talking about saving money because they had to pay for their own college and living expenses. About 5 minutes prior to this conversation, Both peers had ordered the cheap dinner options and declined a shopping trip later that night, while rich girl was talking non-stop about buying the best most expensive souvenirs for her friends. Once tried working a regular person retail job and quit within a couple weeks as it just wasn't right and I didn't like it. Reed had actual responsibilities for the first time. Moved cross-country for an 8-month education course, where her parents pay food, rent, and school. They also gave her a debit card which replenishes up to $500 when it hits $50. She still posts Snapchats with captions of that broke person life over pictures of her getting Starbucks every day, and insists she could survive on her own. Constantly suggests the most expensive options for meals, activities, etc., and tax on things like we can just split the bill. I know you're saving but it's just, amount at least $50. You'll be fine right then gets upset when people can't afford to spend time with her, or when someone dares to suggest that she helps cover costs. If you want more of the best Reddit videos from this side of the universe, please subscribe.